So let's talk about the two ways of doing freehand drawing inside of GIMP. So you have the paintbrush tool accessed with P on the keyboard, and if we left click and drag it around, you'll notice it does very standard brush strokes. Exactly how those strokes are going to look depends on the settings that you have set over in the tool options, and there's many different settings there, such as choosing the brush pattern itself with this drop-down window, controlling the size of the brush, basically if you want the strokes to be larger or smaller, the aspect ratio, which is talking about your width versus your height of the brush stroke. So if we increase the aspect ratio, you'll notice that it shrinks dramatically vertically. If we had a negative aspect ratio, it would have the same effect but in reverse. So we would have a very tall stroke that isn't wide at all. By setting an angle to the brush, we would be able to, as you would imagine, draw at an angle. So you don't even need to necessarily have an angle-sensitive drawing pin in order to do that. Note that adding angle is only going to affect anything if your drawing brush isn't perfectly spherical like the standard drawing brushes. So if I have a 38 degree angle and I draw again, it's going to look exactly like having a 0 degree angle with the same brush. But if I change to a different one, like over here, this pencil scratch, adding an angle is going to rotate the direction at which that brush does a stroke. If we want to decrease the frequency at which the brush applies to the screen, we can increase the spacing. So now if I draw it here, you'll notice that there's a large gap between where each of these little brush patterns are actually added to the screen. So likewise, I can reverse that, make it a low spacing, and then I'd be able to brush much more smoothly, looking a lot more like one uniform brush strip. So the brush hardness is what will give it this very solid edge. If you look at the first brush we had, that actually had a hardness of 50, but this pencil scratch by default has a hardness of 100, which we'll zoom in here and you can see the difference. The hard brush edge doesn't have a lot of blurring on the edges, but as you decrease the hardness and you try to stroke, then the further you get out of the center of that brush stroke, the more blurry it's going to be. So it'll give you a very different look. So brush force is, roughly speaking, how firmly you want to apply the brush onto the image, which if you think of it in terms of paper, it's like how hard you press down on the brush pen. So if you were drawing with a drawing tablet, the force that you actually apply to your pen would impact how hard it actually gets applied to the image. You can also manually change the force to a lower number, and then if we draw, you'll see that it only kind of partially applies to the image, but if we have a high force, then it's going to apply much more firmly. Now it's a little different than brush opacity or the alpha, because a low force will also give you a similar look as a low hardness where you get kind of blurriness around those edges. But if you were to pump the force up to 100, it would be as if you were applying it very hard onto the image. And so it's going to more fully flesh out those edges. Of course, the hardness will still have an impact on the blurriness of it, but less so than with a low force. So speaking of opacity, and opacity is a very important subject for GIMP, or really any video or photo editing program. So opacity is how transparent you want something to be. And in this case, we're talking about brush strokes, but that can also be referring to entire layers of your image. So you can see over there that you can also set the opacity for individual layers. But when we're talking about paint brush strokes, we're talking about how much transparency you want to add to what you are drawing. So if I click down here in the layers box and I create a new layer, and then I click on the active foreground color and I change that to something that's not black so that we can see the difference, and I hit OK, and then I start drawing over my old brush strokes, but with a percentage opacity that's lower than 100%, then what is going to happen is you'll be able to see part of the background come forward in our final image. So you can see that this brush stroke made with 55% transparency allows a lot of the background layer to actually show through despite the new layer we created being on top. So using partially transparent opacity becomes an interesting way to do things like add a little bit of extra color to part of your image without completely changing and overriding the color to something like a pure red. We can get something like this where you can kind of still see the darkness of the black behind it rather than 100% opacity, which just completely overrides whatever's on back of it. Now, because we're working with layers, of course, it's not really overriding it, but it's more layered on top of it. So if I hide the new layer, then you can still see what's behind it. But if you were to export your final image away from GIMP, then this 100% not transparent red would be the final result you would get in the final image. In other words, when it comes to exporting away from GIMP, what you see is what you get. So now to briefly touch on the pencil tool, in 9 out of 10 things, it works the same way as the brush tool. You're still editing the same settings, size, aspect ratio, angle, opacity, the color you want to draw with, and so on. But the difference is that whenever you use the pencil tool, you are drawing with a hard edge, which is going to give you a very different look, and in many cases, you may not want that. So you can see how using this pencil scratch brush, we were able to get kind of a smoother look, because GIMP is simulating a brush stroke. But if you imagine trying to do that with a pencil, you'd get something more like this, where you'd get that very grainy lead look. And if we zoom in, you can see that on the edges here, there is 100% hardness. There's no anti-aliasing at all, which is where you get kind of that blurry smoothness on the edge of a brush stroke. So the difference here really is that whenever you make a stroke with a pencil, hardness is completely ignored. There'll be no blur on the edge of your stroke. And it will get that very, very rough edge look. Now, in some cases, you may actually want that. So you can see here that I switched back to the 50% hardness circular brush, which normally with a brush stroke, and I'll show that here really quickly, will give you that blurriness around the edges. But as soon as we use the pencil tool, there is no blur whatsoever. It just applies the color in full. Now, things like opacity will still affect it. So if you want to draw over something with partial opacity, you can still do that with the pencil tool. But regardless, you're going to get that very hard edge with your drawing. Now, as far as image manipulation goes, you are almost never going to actually want that. Usually things look better when the edges kind of blend together better with your overall image. It looks a lot less harsh. But it's good to know that the pencil tool exists there if you ever need it. But in most likely 99% of cases, you're just going to stick to the paintbrush tool.